Hi there. My name is Mike McLernan. I'm with the Wireless Technical Marketing Group at MathWorks, and I'm here to tell you about a little demo that we have put together on 6G, not 5G, but 6G. So let me share you a little bit about the hardware. First, this large box here, that is an NI VST, Vector Signal Transceiver. So what it has inside, this is an embedded controller, essentially an embedded computer that is running MATLAB. So also, and it will control this RFSG, RF signal generator, and it will come out of this wire with an 800 megahertz wide signal. Now that far exceeds any max bandwidth that 5G can muster. Max 5G bandwidth is 400 megahertz. We are pumping out 800 right here. We go into this mini circuit splitter, and then we go into two channels into this NI X410 USRP radio. Okay, 800 megahertz inside, but the max bandwidth on each channel of the X410 is only 400 megahertz. So each channel filters down to 400 megahertz, but in contiguous bands. So you've got two 400 megahertz signals. Remember that. Then we come back out of the radio, back into the embedded controller and MATLAB, where those two 400 megahertz signals get stitched back together and to make the composite 800 megahertz 6G exploration signal. At which point we will do some analysis, some error vector magnitude EVM analysis on that signal. Here we see some graphical outputs from running these two scripts, but before I dive too deeply into that part, I do want to mention the products that were used to create these demos. MATLAB, of course, but also on the transmit side to interface with the VST, we used the instrument control toolbox, and then to interface with the USRP radios, that would be wireless test bench. So those are the two premier products that we're using to connect to hardware, but also to generate that 6G exploration signal. MathWorks has a 6G exploration library that if you have 5G toolbox, you can download this library for free. So now let's talk a little bit about these graphics. In the upper left, you see a transmit spectrum of an 800 megahertz OFDM signal. So you see it's nice and flat and beautiful, nice steep skirts off the stop band. On the right side, that is the receive spectrum. So you see a little bit of a DC null there at zero. You see a little spur over on the left, and then some very noticeable roll off on the right side. All that says is that even though we're going over a wire, that is so broadband that you're still going to see some distortions. So an improvement opportunity is to use a really broad beam antenna and see if we can get as flat a passband as possible on the receive end as we have on the transmit end. And then finally, the constellation diagram on the lower left, that is the received constellation diagram with the impairments that you see spectrally on the right. So you can certainly identify this as a 16 QAM signal, but it's not pinpoints. You got serious clouds there. So again, opportunities for making this even better. And then if you look at the lower right-hand side on the command window with the scrolling, you can see that the RMS EVM is roughly 13 or so percent, which is not bad, but we look forward to hacking away more at this example, this demo, and making it even better.
To learn more about the tools used to create this demo, please see these links. Thanks very much. Bye.